Peptides, growth factors, and so-called drone delivery. Medik8's reformulated liquid peptides promises firmer, plumper skin with cutting-edge technology. But does it actually improve collagen production and fine lines, or is this just an expensive marketing upgrade? As always, let's look at the science, the texture, and whether it is worth your money. Welcome back to my channel. I'm Dr. Anne, a medical doctor here to teach you how to best take care of your skin and general well-being. Medik8 claims both an instant and a long-term effect on fine lines and deep-set wrinkles. A reduction in fine lines, referred to as expression lines, within 10 minutes after application, and a reduction in deeper wrinkles after 8 weeks of consistent use. They also claim to help support collagen, elastin, and hyaluronic acid production, leading to plumper, firmer skin over time. To support these claims, they conducted several studies, both clinical and consumer studies, with a small number of participants, yes, but still something I enjoy seeing. Like many fragrance-free products, there is a faint scent you'll notice when you sniff it, something a little nutty and warm, but very faint. The serum itself is milky white and quite runny, which makes it easy to spread on the skin and very lightweight, so great for layering. I did experience minimal tackiness for about a minute after application, but after that, Liquid Peptides Advanced MP had completely absorbed, leaving the skin feeling very smooth. Growth factors are supposed to go on clean skin, so the best time for application is directly after cleansing. It can be used both morning and night. I used it mainly at night because that is when it fit my routine best. But wanted to mention that for the wrinkle reduction reported in their consumer studies, after 8 weeks, the serum was used twice a day. Now, I don't think more is more here, and would suspect using it once a day should be enough, but if you want to replicate the effect done in the studies, you should of course follow their protocol. According to the brand, the serum is safe to layer with both exfoliating acids, here you should exfoliate first and use the serum afterwards, as well as with retinoids, making it suitable for whenever in your routine you want to put it. They also did a consumer study testing its use alongside injectables, so it is safe to use with fillers and Botox, apparently even showing self-perceived improvements in how the skin looks then. But something I really appreciate, they don't sell it as alternative to injectable, as some Botox in a bottle brands do, just as supporting act and weaker alternative for those that don't want in-office procedures. Let me quickly say a few words about amino acids, peptides, and proteins first, so you better understand what the dual mini proteins are Medik8 has as new breakthrough ingredients. Amino acids are organic compounds with a carboxyl and an amino group in their structure. That isn't important here, though. More important is that they are very small and used as building blocks in the body. Several amino acids linked make a peptide chain, with the function of the peptide being determined by the type and the order in which the amino acids are combined, and are, obviously, as they are linked amino acids, bigger than amino acids. Peptides have several different functions in the body. They act as signaling molecule for different processes, for example, telling cells what to do more or less of. They are also the building blocks of proteins. Proteins are both the building blocks of structures in the human body. They are part of your cells, your muscles, your skin, your hair, but they also form enzymes, antibodies, and hormones, making them absolutely essential for a functioning human body. In the form of enzymes, they catalyze many important processes related to collagen production or formation of pigmentation, for example, making them interesting in skincare as well as in overall health. Problem is, they are the biggest of the three, and when it comes to topical products, size does matter for penetration. This is where the mini proteins come in, which are, according to Medik8, sitting in the middle between peptides and proteins in size, combining the better penetration of peptides with a bigger impact of protein. Microproteins are an interesting topic of research in medicinal chemistry, but this is the first time I have heard them mentioned in context of skincare, which is why I can't give you any information on how they perform for the purpose of firmer skin. All I can say is that they are a thing, not just a marketing term, and have already been used in nasal sprays aiming to prevent SARS-CoV-2 infections in humans, for example. Now that we have established what dual mini proteins are, here is what Medik8 uses. A combination of two mini proteins called expression line mini protein to relax the muscles and soften expression lines, like argireline, the peptide claims to do, and growth factor mini protein to help stimulate collagen, elastin, and hyaluronic acid production, like well, growth factors. They also use their 30% multi-peptide complex, a proprietary blend of 13 different peptides, including copper peptides, to target different signs of aging. Peptides are an umbrella term, meaning they can do different things: improve hydration, stimulate collagen, affect hyperpigmentation, basically everything you might need for healthy looking skin. So having different ones combined in one product is helpful, unless you prefer combining different serums individually, which is of course fine as well. Here is what we need to talk about drone delivery and what it means in skincare. Peptides often have a hard time getting into the skin due to size and polarity, and as they are targeting signaling molecules, they ideally not just get into the skin, but to a very specific structure there. To help with that, the peptides get encapsulated in a sort of shell that both helps them penetrate unharmed and leads them to their ideal destination due to specific markers on the outer layer of the shell. Here, the copper peptides are directed to the fibroblasts, where they are supposed to help stimulate collagen production. When you look at the ingredient list, you'll see that it contains a multitude of peptides and amino acids belonging to these two ingredient complexes. On top of that, there is glycerin, sodium hyaluronate, and a few sugars as humectants, panthenol for soothing, and skin-identical lipids. It also contains dimethicone, probably responsible for the smooth feeling on the skin. The main focus in all that is, however, the variety of peptides. Yes, the Medik8 Liquid Peptides Advanced MP Serum is very expensive. 100 euro for 30 milliliters is a lot. And no, it did not magically make my deep wrinkles disappear within the 2 months I have been using it. But still, it has quickly become a favorite of mine. It has a beautiful, lightweight texture that offers some hydration, less than a moisturizer, but enough to plump up the skin, which in combination with the dimethicone will smoothen fine lines. The peptide complex used reads like the who is who of peptides targeting signs of aging, and both the drone delivery as well as the dual mini peptides used are an interesting development. Interesting, not groundbreaking, proven scientific discoveries that will change the way we do skincare, but great for someone that likes to step up their basics with more experimental stuff. On the background of Medik8 being a brand that does their own studies, trying to integrate new things in their product development, for me the price is justified. You will always pay more for those putting in the work than you will for those copying the results once they are already established. I am aware though that this is more than most people have in their budget for skincare, so let me assure you, if you don't spend that much, you will not miss out. There are other very nice peptide serum out there for a fraction of the price, and if drone delivery and mini peptides will make an actual visible difference in how we age over the course of 10 years, certainly less than using sunscreen regularly will. Still, I am in love. And if you enjoyed this video, you will most likely enjoy the ones linked on the screen here. Don't forget to check out the description box for everything else I have to offer, and like and subscribe to this channel so you don't miss the next video.